Our next operation is to perform the search based on the names that we have entered. So we can see here we are having these many names. So let us perform the search operation. So the name that I have given is Gauri and I say search. So you can see all the details related to that particular name are getting displayed. Suppose I change the name and I give a name that does not exist in the database. I say search. So it is giving me that Shetty doesn't exist. Now we have a name which is having duplicate values. So we say search. So all the details are also getting displayed here. Now let us see the code. This is the PHP script for the search operation. We again have to establish the connection with this particular dollar link, that is the handler. So this is also there in our insert code. Now we have declared a variable here, dollar name. Now in this particular variable, I am trying to store the value that has been entered in the form. That is, this S name is coming from this particular form. You can see here, name, input type is text, and name is S name. Let us have a look at the form here. So this is the input type name, and the name that is given to this text box is S name. Then we have a button here. So this particular value, when the user enters the data into this particular text box, that is going to be fetched here through the method post, because we have also specified the method for search operation as post. Then I have declared one variable dollar result, and in this variable I have written my query, my SQLi query, and this is dollar link, so that we can understand to which database and in which table we have to perform this search operation. Now, instead of, if you observe the insert code here, in my SQLi query, I have passed two variables. That is, one is the link and one more is the query. And this is the query we have written. But here, if you see in the search operation, in my SQLi query, I have given dollar link. And instead of writing one more, passing one more variable, I have directly passed the query. So you can either do it by the first method or by this second method. So if you want, you declare one more variable here, write this query inside that, and just pass the query, just pass the variable in which you're storing. Otherwise, directly write the query here. Write comma, and in the double quotes, you will write the query. A query is what? Select star from which table. We want all the details to be fetched. So we are making use of the star operation. Star means it is going to get us all the values. From which table we have to specify? The table is student underscore table. Now, which values, how are you going to match? So based on this where clause. So here we are saying where name. This name comes from this particular column in the database, where this name is equal to dollar name. Dollar name is where? Here. This is a dollar name. What does it consist? It consists the value that has been entered by the user in the form. So where the name from the database is equal to the name that is entered by the user. Then we have a if condition. In the if condition here, we are checking if the particular name that has been entered by the user in the form exists or not. So if it does not exist, a message is going to be displayed saying that particular name doesn't exist. If it exists, then the details are going to be displayed. So here you can see here my SQLi num rows of dollar result. Now this variable is storing or selecting all the values from that student table, and here it is checking. Now what we have to understand here is, whenever the values are getting selected from the database, we are storing it in a particular variable. So in this dollar result, if any value is actually existing from the database, it is going to be stored here. So if the value exists, it is not going to be equal to zero, means we have values to display it. So the else part gets executed. So when is dollar result equal to zero? When the value does not exist in our database, that is no row is fetched. So the result variable is equal to zero. If at all a value is fetched, that is when this result variable will be having and storing some actual data. So that is when it enters the else part. So here if you see, when I enter the name and I click search, it is having two rows. So these two rows are getting stored in the variable $res. And here in this if condition, we are checking, is this dollar result having any rows? So here we can see it is having two rows. So the value is not equal to zero. That is why we are not getting this message, but this else part is getting executed. So if at all the value you search this select query and it does not have anything to fetch from the database, that time the value that is stored in $SCR will be equal to zero. Now let us see how to display. We have made use of echo statement. Now we have to display it in the form of a table here. So here you can see the values are getting displayed in the form of a table. So inside double quotes, you have to write the table tag. So if you do not want this borders and alignment, you can remove this and just specify table. Then end this particular tag, take another echo statement, or you can just continue inside the, here inside the double quotes. So I have taken one more echo statement, opened the double quote here. Now I have to create rows for this. So the rows are getting created. Inside this particular row, I will require how many data. This is the row that we have created. So inside this particular row, we require four headings: name, address 1, address 2, and address 3. So we require four columns. So these TD are doing the task of creating those particular columns. Also, we have given the width and align center so that the name is aligned at the center. Then you close the respective TD tags and then you close the row tag. So this particular creation of this first row is done. This row is done. Now this, if you observe here, the double quotes is ending here and the semicolon is terminated. So this entire four lines is a one line code. So instead of going horizontally here, I've just taken it on the next tab. Do not assume these to be four separate lines. Then I have a while loop here. Next. Now inside the while loop, I have again declared a variable $ARR. So it is going to fetch row. You have a function here, MySQLi, fetch row of $result. Now what is stored in $result? The select query. That is the values that are fetched from by selecting from the database is stored in the $result. So now you have to display it in the form of a table. So we are making of the while loop. So if our result contains two values, this loop will execute two times. If it contains three values, this loop will execute three times. Then again, I have taken an echo to display output on the screen. And here I have created a row here. So which is the row? This is the row that I have created. Inside the row, we again require four columns. Array of zero, you remember indexed arrays. So array of zero means the name value is fetched. Array of one, the address one value is fetched. Array of two, address two is fetched. And array of three,
that is email is fetched and is getting displayed and you close the row. So based on the values that you store in result, those many number of rows are going to be generated. Then end the while loop. After that, you end the table tag. You have to end this table tag. Close the semicolon, terminate it with a semicolon and close the bracket and close the PHP script. So this is your journal program number 9.